plane accident was not forgotten.
The PTA meeting started with a play by the 4-H Club. The play was dedicated to those involved in the school bus train accident. The dedication and the play were well received. The play was followed by a prayer, also directed to those who had been injured in the accident.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
I'd like to hear anyone named in this. J.T. Holliday or T.J. Holliday, whichever his name is. The driver of the train.
Then it was the appearance of business as usual. The reading of minutes, old business, new business, and adjournment. No mention of the accident was raised. Some of the parents here were pleased with that, others were not, and still others were surprised it wasn't.
Well, I think they both talked out. I really do.
I was kind of disappointed that they didn't say anything about it, because we discussed it once before about the putting crossings at all the railroad signs and everything. And
I thought something would be said about it, but... You know, well, I always come to the PTA meetings, but I just, you know, thought that something would be said, but nothing was said. I was really surprised.
Administrators say they want to put behind them the accident and the media coverage and proceed with business as usual, but that seems to be a little bit more difficult to do than to say. So for now, for the sake of the students, administrators are settling for appearances.
Here has the night off. Last week's accident involving a school bus and a freight train in Carsville has claimed its first fatality. The school bus driver, Carol Cusick, died this evening in Norfolk General Hospital with multiple injuries. As a result of the accident, Mrs. Cusick had lost both legs, her condition critical from the time of the accident, never substantially improved. Of the seven people hospitalized after the accident, two student passengers are still in the hospital. Tracy Langford is in satisfactory condition at Norfolk General, and Thomas Faison is in fair condition at Children's Hospital of the King's Daughters. Meanwhile, the state and federal investigators are still trying to determine how the accident happened. Although the investigation is not complete, a federal safety investigator is saying improvements in school bus construction may have kept the body of the bus from being ripped apart when it collided with that seaboard freight train. As stronger construction, the investigator says, may well have helped save lives.